The P45, also known as the P71 on Amazon, is one of Yamaha's best-selling digital pianos, and that's no surprise. Many piano teachers around the world recommend it to their beginner students because the Yamaha brand is more than a century old, and it is Yamaha's cheapest 88-key hammer action keyboard. However, before you rush out and buy one, there are things you need to know so you won't get any nasty surprises when you start playing it for the first time. If you're looking for a keyboard with hundreds or even thousands of sounds, the Yamaha P45 isn't the one for you. This keyboard is predominantly a digital piano first, and most people who buy it are those who don't really use the other sounds. The P45 comes with 10 voices, and what it lacks in quantity, it makes up for it in quality. You get two grand piano voices, one sampled from Yamaha's concert grand piano, which is the default sound. And the other is a brighter piano tone better suited for use when playing with other instrumentalists. There are two electric piano tones. One is the iconic Rhodes electric piano sound. And the other is from Yamaha's iconic 1980s DX7 keyboard. There are also two organ tones, an intimate Baroque era organ, and a grander sounding cathedral pipe organ. Harpsichords suitable for those who enjoy Baroque music are also in this keyboard. Finally, there is a strings section. And a vibraphone tone suitable for dual voice layering, which the P45 is capable of. For most beginners, these 10 voices are more than sufficient. You would need to look at the more expensive Yamaha P125 or digital pianos from Casio, Roland, and Korg if you need bass instrument sounds and the ability to split voices across the keyboard. You can find my recommended keyboards and digital pianos in the description below. Serious classical pianists will find the 64-note polyphony on the Yamaha P45 to be inadequate. Note polyphony is the number of notes that can sound at once. Advanced pianists will be frustrated with note drop-offs when playing demanding music. While this will not be an issue for beginners, similarly priced digital pianos from other brands now have 128 and even 256 note polyphony. Check out the description if you want to find out what these other digital pianos are. An acoustic piano typically has three pedals, soft, sostenuto, and damper. The P45 supports only the damper pedal, also known as the sustain function. This rules out the P45 for more serious pianists playing more demanding music, but beginners will do fine without it. Thankfully, half pedaling is supported on the P45 if you purchase an additional sustain pedal. Almost every other digital piano in my recommended list supports a triple pedal system. Check it out if you're interested. Without an LCD screen, even a basic one, it can be frustrating at times not knowing what voice I have selected and the other parameters I may have changed, such as transposition, reverb, velocity curve, or the metronome tempo. An absolute beginner will not use these functions much, and having no LCD screen will not be a deal breaker. But there are a number of competing brands at a similar price with an LCD screen, making operating the keyboard less challenging. You can find digital pianos with an LCD screen in the description below. The Yamaha P45 can only be powered through an electrical outlet. That may be a deal breaker for some who may bring their keyboards to busk, gig, or jam with friends, and an electrical outlet may not be within reach. The P45 has a pair of 6-watt amplifiers which can be easily powered with a set of AA batteries, a welcome feature a few competing brands have. I have a list of digital pianos that can be battery operated in the description below. The Yamaha P45 is a 6-year-old model, and it is beginning to show its age where connectivity options are concerned. While there is the usual USB MIDI connector for use with music learning apps on your smartphone and tablet, I am dismayed that Yamaha didn't include an auxiliary audio input with the P45. Many beginner music books now come with backing tracks you can download onto your phone. Learning with an audio backing track on the phone routed through the keyboard's onboard speakers with a cymbal cable helps my student keep better time as well as make learning more interesting. Wireless Bluetooth audio, a feature that is pretty standard on many digital pianos from competing brands, is also lacking. And if you want to connect the P45 to more powerful speakers, the lack of a pair of 1/4-inch stereo outputs can be a deal breaker. With these shortcomings, should you still buy a Yamaha P45? That depends. If you are an absolute beginner, the Yamaha P45 continues to be a solid choice. With even a $50 price increase due to the global chip shortage, the P45 remains the cheapest digital piano from Yamaha with 88 hammer action keys. The GHS key action, while not the shiniest, is well established. Coupled with the time-tested AWM voice samples, it will satisfy most, if not all, beginners. Even though the P45 is built like a tank with a chunky design, it remains relatively lightweight should you need to move it around. The well-known Yamaha brand also guarantees a better resale value versus other brands should you upgrade in the future. Compared to lesser-known brands, Yamaha spare parts availability as well as customer service is significantly better. Nonetheless, you can find a list of my recommended digital pianos, keyboards, and music learning apps in the description and comments section below. My name is Jeremy C, and I'll see you in my next video.